Let's do a quick review of what we saw this week. Adding and subtracting numbers. But the first part, on Monday, we learn how to do it using an elevator, right? And for elevators, I was using a number line. So let's see. I remember I used black for my number line here. And I said, let me write my zero there. And I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and there's positive 10. If I need to go higher than 10, I can always extend my number line. Below, I'm gonna go -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. It is okay to be negatives. Again, I mentioned on Monday that we can go to a building. Here in Bakersfield as well, but we can have basements. Here, you should go up to just -1, only one floor down. But in other cities, you go more than one floor down. So -1, -2. I don't know. You can go as far as you need to go. So for question number 15, we're going to start a floor 2. So here I am. I'm on 2. I'm going to go up 3. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. So here I am. And then I'm going to go up 1. So here I'm on floor 6 now. I'm gonna go down 4. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I'm floor 2 now. I'm gonna go up 2. So here I am here. And then lastly, I'm gonna go down 3 floors. So this is where I finish. That's floor 1. So my answer is 1. Or we could have seen it as 2 plus 3 plus 1 minus 4 plus 2 minus 3. That kind of sounds not too fun. Let's take a look at question number 16. Right, we're going to start with 4. And going down is minus, going up is plus. So I can see this as pluses or minus, or I can see this as a number line. Let's do my number line here. Zeros right there. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. There's positive 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and there's positive 10. And going down 2, right? I go down to negative 5. Again, if I need to go higher than 10, by all means, extend your number line. If you need to go lower than negative 5, by all means, extend your number line. All right, so I'm going to start a 4. So I'm going to start here. That's where I start. Now I'm going to go down 3. 1, 2, 3. So this is where I'm at now. I'm on floor 1. But then I'm going to go up 2. So there. I'm on floor 3 now. Then I'm going to go up 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. That's floor 8 now. I gotta go up 6. Oh, don't have enough room. Remember, I said earlier, if you need to extend your number line, by all means do so. So let's see, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. If you need to extend the number line, extend it. So, okay, so I was here at floor 8, and it says I have to go up 6, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There, I'm at level 14 now. Then I have to go down 3. 1, 2, 3. This is numbered 11. But then we also talk about bank accounts. Let's take a look at number 17. Withdraw means minus, right? Because we're going to take money out of the account. Deposit means plus because we're going to add money to the account. So in this account, I'm going to begin with $135, but let me subtract 23. 135 minus 23, it gives me 112. But then let me deposit. So plus 42, 112 plus 42, it gives me 154. Then I'm going to deposit 63 more. So plus 63, that gives me 217. But then I have a withdrawal, minus 27. So 217 minus 27, that gives me 190. And then plus 20, that's deposit. So plus 20, it gives me 210. All right, let's take a look at number 18. In this case, we're going to begin with 325. Withdraw again means minus, deposit means plus, right? Withdraw means we take money out of the account, so the money goes down, right? The balance goes down. Deposit means we add money to the account. So we start with 325 minus 63. That gives me 262. But then I'm going to deposit. So plus 14, that gives me 276. But then I withdraw 75. 276 minus 75, that gives me 201. Then I withdraw again. So minus 80. 201 minus 80 gives me 121. And then plus 10, because deposit means plus, 121 plus 10, that is 131. But then we also saw adding and subtracting like these. I'm looking at question 19 and 20. And then I said, look at this as a scoreboard. Positives and negatives are playing each other. First of all, write everything without parentheses. So I have 3 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2. I wrote that as a plus because I remember I said two negative signs make a plus sign. Now, if the signs were different, the two signs that are together, a plus and a minus were put together, I'll call that minus, okay? So I'm going to separate positives and negatives. So the first number is positive 3. So that one goes with the positives. The second number, positive 3. Second number, positive 4. And lastly, positive 2. All right, so let me add all my positive numbers. 3 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2. That's 12. Let me add all the negative points. Nothing. The negative score, nothing. My final question here is, who won by how much? We can say the positives won by 12. Now, we don't have to write the positive sign. So just positive 12 is enough. If I was to say, what's 3 plus 3 plus 4 minus a negative 2? We're going to say 12. All right, let's take a look at question number 20. Let me write everything without parentheses. So 7 plus 2 plus 8 plus 7. Let me separate my positives and my negatives. So positive 7, positive 2, positive 8, positive 7. When I add all my positive points, 7 plus 2 plus 8 plus 7, that's 24. The negatives, well, they have nothing. So 24 to 0, who won? The positive scored 24 points and the negative scored 0 points. Well, the positive won by 24 points. So positive 24.